our efforts.
2500多年前，当释迦牟尼佛仍是王子时，亲眼目睹了人世间之生老病死。他告诉自己，一定要找到一条永恒之路。于是他放弃了王位及荣华富贵，四处去找寻名师及永久解脱的法门。后来燃灯古佛为他受记，最后他修成了正果，也留下了许多的经典，引导众生开悟正果。
About 2,500 years ago, when Shakyamuni Buddha was still a prince, he witnessed the four sufferings of life, birth, old age, sickness and death. He told himself, I've got to find the way that leads to eternity. Thus, he gave up his throne and fortune in search for an enlightening master and the way to eternal liberation. Later, he was initiated by Dipankara Buddha and eventually reached Buddhahood. Shakyamuni Buddha's teachings were collected by his disciples as sutras. The large collection of sutras have continued to guide sentient beings even till this day.
在一般人的思维里，极有价值、罕有又很不容易得到的东西，而且是人类所一直在追求的，我们才会称之为宝。今天您在上天的恩典及诸佛菩萨的祝福下求了道，得了三宝。这道就是当初佛陀及无往今来的修行者宗教家倾一生之力所追寻的永恒之路。过去因为天时未至，道是单传独授，得道者稀，修行者常有踏破铁鞋无觅处之憾。如今上天慈悲大开普渡，得道者众，求道者可说是得来全不费功夫。虽然得道容易，也是自己累世佛缘根基深厚，祖上有德所致。所以当您求完道时，大家都给您道喜。
Generally, we call a precious, valuableand rare item which is highly sought after as a treasure. Today, because of the grace of heaven and the blessings from all Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, you have received Dao and the three treasures. Dao is the way to eternity that Shakyamuni Buddha, countless cultivators,and religious people have been searching all their lives. Before 1930, Dao was transmitted on a one-to-one basis. An enlightening master could only transmit Dao to a one-qualified individual because the timing for universal Dao transmission was not right.The number of people receiving Dao were scarce due to the lack of opportunity to meet with an enlightening master and receive Dao. What a pity! Because of the grace of heaven, now is the time for universal Dao transmission, and therefore, many people had the opportunity to receive Dao.Although it may seem relatively easy to receive Dao, receiving Dao is actually based on your affinity with Buddhas, your deep spiritual foundation, and the beneficence of your ancestors. Thus, after you had received Tao, everybody would express their heartfelt joy and congratulate you.
依照三宝来修行的话，可以帮助我们。第一，跳脱生死轮回；第二，净化我们的业力，改变命运；最后，返回天上的故家乡。
Practicing these three treasures can truly help us in the following ways. 1. Transcending the cycle of life and death. 2. Cleansing our karma, changing our destiny, and eventually returning to our heavenly home.
一般的人由于业力的牵引，不得不再度来到这世界上，每来一次又会造些业。漫漫的人生路上，总是有着诸多的不如意、抱怨、忧愁、烦恼、病痛等。面对命运的枷锁与生死的轮回，却不知所措，更无法跳脱出来，实属无奈。
Because most people as destiny are led by their karma, they have to go through the cycle of life and death repeatedly without choice. Each cycle of life and death would accumulate some karma, good and bad. Therefore, their long journey of life would be filled with different kinds of complaints, worries,annoyances, sickness, and sufferings. Life that's journey is never what we expected. Most people are imprisoned by fate and trapped in the cycle of life and death. They feel helpless because they failed to find a way to become liberated.
我们人的身体只是灵性暂时居住的房子，当生命旅程结束时，灵性会脱离身体进入另外一个世界，而求道时得到的三宝就是回天的凭证，这也是人生中最重要的一件事。以下事项是需要您放在心上的，一，不要忘记三宝，也不可以泄露三宝；二，不反道败德；三，多了愿，多行功立德。如此，我们才可以回天上的故家乡。
Our physical body is a temporary home for our soul.When the journey of our life comes to an end, our soul will leave the body and enter another world. The three treasures you have received are the token for returning to the heavenly home. They are the most important things in our lives. The following are the three main points that you need to keep in mind.1. Do not forget and disclose the three treasures. 2. Do not do anything illegal, immoral, or harmful to yourself and others. 3. Do as much as you can to fulfill your vows and accumulate merits and virtues. By following these three points, you will be able to return to the heavenly home.
现在让我们来简单地介绍一下三宝。
Now, let us briefly introduce the three treasures.
第一宝，玄关窍，灵性进出的门户。
The first treasure, heavenly portal, the main gate to our true nature / true self.
在庄严神圣的修道仪式中，见传师在我们的玄关窍这么一点， 点燃了自信之光明，当下全乖巧，立刻现出了如同绿豆大小般之国光。我们可以看一下各宗教圣人的画像，每位圣人之头骨都有一个光圈，此光乃是自信之光。借着后续的修行及行功立德，此国光会逐渐扩大，最后就像各教圣人的光圈一样地光亮圆满，展现出来的智慧及德行随着因缘愿力而四处利益众生。
During the solemnant holy now receiving ceremony, now transmitting Master want at our heavenly portal to illuminate the light of our true nature. A small halo will radiate from the heavenly portal immediately afterwards. If we look at the portraits of the saints from different religions,we will see that they all had one thing in common, which is the halo behind each saint's head. The halo is the light emitted from the true nature. The halo will expand in accordance with our cultivation and accumulation of merits and virtues. Eventually,our halos can be as round and bright as the halos of the saints. Then, the wisdom and virtue we exhibit will accompany our vows and affinities to benefit all mankind.